up in the sky. Look, it's captivating. It's energizing. It's Eliances Heroes. Eliances is the destination for entrepreneurs, investors, CEOs, inventors, leaders, celebrities, and startups, where our heroes in business align. Now, here's your host flying in, David Kogan, founder of Eliances.
That's right, and I'm sure you all have missed me, especially from last week when we had Cheryl Crow on and learned many secrets about her. Well, today is going to be absolutely phenomenal. Wait until you see and hear who we've got coming on. Later on in the show, we've got Chris Camacho, Greater Phoenix Economic Council President. And later on, we're also going to have Travis Watts, VP of Investor Relations at Direct Source Wealth. Make sure you go to directsourcewealth.com/hero. And by the way, thank you for the feedback we continue to get from having the CEO of Dollar Days that was at our last grand table. Make sure you go to Eliances.com. That's Eliances.com, the only place where entrepreneurs align. Well, speaking of nonprofits, our next hero is the president of Junior Achievement of Arizona. They do so much for students and young adults, and we have the opportunity to meet and talk with Katherine Cecala, who can be reached at jaaz.org, or of course, we'll have that on our website at eliances.com. Katherine, let's talk about Junior Achievement. It's been around for over 60 years in Arizona. How have you seen things develop during, you know, the time, especially maybe within the last 5 years alone?
Well, I think over the 6 years we've been in Arizona, we have moved from an after-school program to being in the classroom so that we're able to serve even more kids. We are serving 83,000 primarily low-income kids in Arizona through the classroom and using 9,000 volunteers to do that. So what we've seen in recent years is more and more schools asking for this program because they see how it makes a difference.
Now, there may be some people, most people have heard of Junior Achievement. Not everyone has had the opportunity to actually participate. So tell us a little bit more about what Junior Achievement is and the impact that it makes.
Junior Achievement is about trying to help our young people be prepared to succeed in work and life. And we do that by teaching them skills about financial literacy, entrepreneurship, and work readiness.
My favorite subjects. Now, what's interesting is that you have a law degree. So what inspired you to go into the nonprofit sector in leadership roles?
Actually, my passion is volunteering, and I have volunteered all my life. I work with lots of different nonprofits. That's what I love to do. Frankly, I just went to law school as a hobby. So being able to be at a nonprofit where during the day I can be making a difference in people's lives, and then outside of work, I can volunteer for numerous other organizations as well.
Oh my God, I wish there were more people like you. Now, you've also run organizations with operating budgets. I mean, we're talking in the hundreds of millions of dollars, like as your role of COO of Sun United Way. And what are some of the ways that individuals and companies can help support like Junior Achievement's efforts?
Junior Achievement has about a $4 million budget, and it's only that low because we have 9,000 volunteers who are delivering our programs. But we're run entirely by philanthropy, so we rely on corporations and foundations and individuals to donate to our programs. It costs us about $36 a student to deliver our programs, and so individuals could donate to us through the Arizona tax credit, as an example. Companies can sponsor shops, they can sponsor schools. Individuals and companies can send volunteers.
Tell me about the volunteer part and what you're looking for, because we have many listeners out there that are involved. They're involved in nonprofits, or they're looking to get involved and looking to help.
We're in about 400 schools throughout the state of Arizona, and in those schools, volunteers go into the classroom and teach the lessons. We provide the curriculum, K through 12, and so volunteers can say, I would really like to do second grade, and I'd really love a school in this section of the valley. And we can try to connect them with that school and that grade and provide the curriculum where they can go into the classroom and teach these important lessons that we know make a difference and incorporate their own story so that they're really a mentor to the kids in that class.
Absolutely phenomenal. You got to get involved. Make sure you go to jaaz.org. Again, you're listening to me, David Kogan, host of the Eliances Hero Show. make sure you go to Eliances.com. That's E-L-I-A-N-C-E-S.com. Again, the only place where entrepreneurs align. Make sure you'll be able to connect with Katherine Cecala, president of Junior Achievement of Arizona, doing so much for our students. It's absolutely phenomenal. Katherine, tell me how, you know, you said mainly within the underprivileged, disadvantaged youths and stuff, giving them the opportunity and the chance. How do you keep them active, though? How do you keep the, I like to say, the stickiness to keep them involved and keep them coming?
One of the great things about our programs is that they're very experiential. So even in the classroom, you might have 10 minutes of lesson followed by 45 minutes of some experience, a game, something where the kids apply what they've learned. So every single module is primarily experiential. That's what makes it stick with the kids.
Now, also, too, is that you're an instructor at ASU in nonprofit and philanthropy. Share with us a couple secrets that you could share about being a leader in nonprofit that must just, the feeling of what you must do and go home every night working in such a nonprofit like Junior Achievement must just be 10 million times payfold.
It does. It's you can feel like you're making a difference. And whether it's with individuals or the community at large, there are so many issues. There's so many great organizations out there. Junior Achievement is one of them. And just to see the difference you're making, one of the things I love about Junior Achievement is that we have data that shows that our programs work. We have data that shows, as an example, that kids who have Junior Achievement have 34% higher critical thinking skills. That's the one thing that employers say is most often missing in the kids that they're trying to hire. So when we see those kids, we see them in action, we hear their reactions, it just makes my day.
And it's to keep them on the right path. And
absolutely,
you're definitely doing that. One of the questions we had somebody submit was they wanted to know what your day-to-day type routine is or activities.
Well, filled with a lot of meetings, like most executives, meeting with people. But I can tell you one of the big perks of my job is that if I'm having a bad day, which isn't very often, I can plop over into BizTown, which is one of our programs that happens to be on site, and where we have about 200 kids every day running mini town, running businesses. So I can just walk over there for 5 minutes and see those kids in action in their little suits and ties trying to pay back a loan. These are like 10-year-olds, and it's a joy. So that's kind of a little perk out of my day.
And what they must learn from that has just got to be phenomenal.
Oh, it is.
All right, we've got just a couple minutes left, but I need to ask you this too. Let's say that you're talking to a class of high school students, which I'm sure that you have, about what you do and how they can make the world a better place. What is the best way for someone to truly make a difference like you are and your career has been and you're doing every single day?
Well, I think that kids, adults too, can make a difference in so many ways. They don't have to work in a nonprofit. They can donate, they can give their time, they can go out there and advocate, be an ambassador for various causes. So we talk to kids, we say, think about what you're passionate about, think about what your skills are, go into those areas. I just happen to be able to apply my engineering and law background in a nonprofit environment, but you can do anything with those skills.
I still am in shock that you went to get your law degree as a hobby. Oh my gosh. Katherine, you help students grow to be successful. That's a hero. You're making a difference. Katherine Cecala, president of Junior Achievement. Make sure you go to jaaz.org. And when coming up next, Chris Camacho, president of Greater Phoenix Economic Council. This is David Kogan with Eliances.